Robin Proper is a Rangers player and Paolo Bernardo is back at Celtic as well. It's all happening, give us a call. Cody, however, is really on to play Beat the Pundit. Have you ever played before, Cody?
No, it's my first time.
Good, good. You do alright though when you play at home?
Yeah, I'm always winning, especially against Gordon Gale.
Oh, here's a Cody.
Fighting talk.
We heard a 6 or 7 the other night there, and the lad bottled it.
Who won last night? I was very busy.
Well, it was Hugh and Jim Duffy, so I'd imagine that.
Oh, Hugh won 6-5.
Ah, well done.
Word reaches me. It's still 2-1 to the listeners this week because they got off to a flying start. What do you think about your chances of playing?
He's quite confident.
Right? If the coin went your way,
we'll see what happens with the coin.
He's got that. Do you know what? I quite like that. Very
never,
confident.
Never
yeah.
played before. Okay.
Probably the first thing you win.
Heads it will be Brian Graham and tails it will be Gordon Dalziel. Yes, it's a heads. I love a debutante.
Oh, Brian, he's balling it now.
Up against Cody.
I'll help you. Don't worry about it.
What we will do is give Brian some greatest hits radio to listen to so that he can hear what's going on. Cody, you've got 30 seconds. Just answer as many as you can. And if you want to pass and move on, that's absolutely fine, okay?
Okay.
Right, 30 seconds on the clock and your time starts now. At which Scottish side did Celtic's James McCarthy start his senior career?
Hibernian.
Which current Rangers player played at the Olympics in 2012?
Mohamed Diamondi.
In what year did Hearts last win the Scottish Cup?
2014.
What Scottish Championship side are nicknamed the Harry Rags?
Pass.
Name either side who were relegated from the Scottish Championship last season.
Arbroath.
Okay, let's bring him back. Brian Graham, can you hear us?
Can't.
Do you want to know what the hardest thing about playing Beat the Pundit
no,
is?
Mate.
Forget the questions. It's that big daft face staring at you.
I was trying not to look at him.
How off-putting is he?
You're a certainty.
It's his eyes. The eyes get bigger.
Do you know what? Just think of this in your head. It's like me going round the goalkeeper, passing it to you, and you tap in. That's Cody's done. He's away.
No, that's him. He's away.
30 seconds to Brian Graham, and his time starts now. Which Scottish side James McCarthy start his senior career?
Hamilton.
Which current Rangers player played at the Olympics in 2012?
Pass.
In what year did Hearts last win the Scottish Cup?
2012.
Which Scottish Championship side are nicknamed the Harry Rags?
The Jags, Partick, Thistle.
Name either side who were relegated from the Scottish Championship last season.
Arbroath.
How many Scottish teams qualified for European competition this season?
4.
Which English Premier League club does Scotland's Ross Stewart play for?
Southampton.
Okay, what are you thinking, Cody?
Get yourself up the road, Cody.
He'll be lucky to sneak a tiebreaker here, I think.
Well, I'm not buying that. He took too long. I was watching you.
We'll see how. So, did you not hear Cody?
No. Well, I could see how long he was taking, but I would imagine Brian's tucked him.
Well, Cody thinks Brian will be lucky to get a tiebreaker. Let's find out. At which Scottish side did Celtic's James McCarthy start his senior career? It's Hamilton. 1-0.
Cody, go to bed, mate.
Not yet.
Give him an early night.
Sneak a tiebreaker. Which current Rangers player played at the Olympics in 2012? Jack Butland. Remember that was the one.
I was going to say Jack Butland.
Remember it was Team GB.
Let's say Cody.
It's the only time recently we've entered a men's Team GB. Actually went to one of the games. One of my mates worked for the Olympics and went to some game.
Are you hearing Trafford?
He's devastated. Absolutely devastated.
Cody's up the road.
Who did you go for again?
I went for Diamandé.
See,
12
years ago, he was only 10. That's the problem. Just missed out. In what year did Hearts last win the Cup? It is 2012. 5-1 win against Hibs, obviously. 2-0.
Cody.
The Harry Rags, Cody. The Jags.
I can't believe that question was in there.
Wait, that's how I knew you won, right? Because he was sitting for about 10 seconds waiting for Cody to even think about that.
3-0 to Brian Graham.
How's your chances now, Cody?
You put the Partick Thistle question. I'm a Partick Thistle player. I don't know about that.
What about the other
fair
two?
Fair point. I'll take that one off and we'll see how you get on. Name either side who were relegated from the Championship last season. This is where Cody sprung into life. Arbroath. You got it as well. Or Inverness.
Yes.
How many Scottish teams qualified for Europe? It was five. You didn't get it. Celtic, Rangers, Hearts, Kelly, St Mirren, and Ross Stewart plays for Southampton. So it was a 5-1 win. For Brian,
what a debut! What a dazzler!
You're right, brilliant, mate. Told you, ring the goalie.
Cody, you're right. That Partick Thistle question's a disgrace.
You can take that point off if
I'll
you want.
Take it off him. Hard lines, Cody.
And we'll double your answer, Cody. So you have a two. Yeah.
Good man, Cody. Take care.
I would have smacked you,
Cody. Cody, honestly, I'd have put you away 10 seconds, no 30 on the clock, mate.
Limit, don't back down.
By the way, how bad are these people, right? They come on. What do you usually do? I usually do very well, 6 or 7.
It's harder when the pressure's on.
He only answers 5 questions, right?
It's harder when the pressure's on.
Bottled it. Cody, pick it up, son, and get yourself up the road.
Do it again sometime, Cody.
I will.
Tighten your belt. Tighten your belt.
Cody from Bonnybridge. 5-1 win for Brian Graham. I just love the sincerity of, like,
he's lucky to get a tiebreak.
Because obviously, like, spoiler, like, me and everyone else has heard those, and I know how many he's got, and I just, I love it. I love the confidence.
I knew right away because I was watching, and he didn't ask him a question for about 10 seconds, and it was a Harry Ragged one.
Harry Rags. I have to admit, with every day being a school day, it says on my sheet, brackets, British jockey, 1902 to 1985. Harry Rag? Yeah? That's where that comes from?
Yeah, that's true.
News to me.
Yeah.
Every day a school day, I know that.
He was a jockey. Do you know how I know that?
All you've done is repeated back what I just said, though.
No, and the reason, but I can back my reason up.
Go for it.
Because when you used to go to the fair, the fair that used to go, and you used to put the pennies in, and the horses...
Where's he gone with us?
Hold on. Hugh'll verify this because he'll be listening. And the horses used to run round, and you could bet Harry Rag used to ride one of the horses. And that's true.
It's not that I don't believe you. Just
I couldn't make that up. No, I'm good at making things up and lying, but I couldn't make that up. Hugh'll back
me
100%.
Hold on, let me finish. It's not that I don't believe you. It's just that surely the go-to there is, yeah, I remember because Harry Rag is a jockey. Like I saw, rather than some mad story about the fair, he would need to be a real jockey first before the fair.
Yeah, but that's how I recognised his name.
Right, okay.
Right, and that's why I know 100% Harry Rag was a jockey.
I like the one where you roll the balls and then the faster you roll them into the hole, then the
the jockey goes
faster.
Well, Harry Rag never...
That's good.
He wasn't riding those days. He was more...
Retired by then.
Yeah, he was retired.
No, I like that. You still on the Olympics? You were soul searching the other night about what event you would take part in.
Yeah, I was watching a wee bit today and the girl, 3 tens with the bow and arrow. Boom, boom, boom. 3 tens.
Do you know what I'd like to see you at?
Told me he's a good golfer. The golf's just started.
That's too obvious. I want to see him do something like left field.
There's not a lot I could do now.
The shooting. You seen the boy, he's like gone wildly viral famous. Is it Turkey's representing? So most of them have got like the protective mask eyewear on, the kind of fancy outfits, accessories, and they look the part, and he's standing, he's just got a t-shirt, he's got his hand in his pocket, and he's like in his 50s.
I watched him the other day.
And everyone's saying he just looks like some retired assassin that they've phoned up and said, listen, go and do us a turn.
But I'll tell you what,
that would be you.
What about the size of the guns?
What about them?
The size of them nowadays?
I don't know.
They're massive. How they can hold them up to... it's not a James Bond one. You know what I mean? It's one of those...
No 007?
The thing's nearly at the target. But I've seen the guy...
You see that guy? He was casual.
And he doesn't... I think he only wears glasses, does he? Just his normal focus.
Just like reading glasses.
Two and a half that you would read with. Boom, boom, boom. See you later next round.
Brilliant. That's...
Are you watching it?
I've watched some of it.
What's your favourite?
I like swimming.
Swimming is good. No, it's exciting.
Boring,
I like it as well.
Is that exciting?
Because it is. I like swimming, so it's one of the ones I like.
That is honestly your Olympic analysis there. I don't think Hazel Irvine has to worry about her job.
Anybody that does a butterfly, I would disqualify. Growing up, you can never want to say, I want to be a gold medal at a butterfly.
Why?
Because it's the worst stroke I've ever seen in my life.
I'd like to see you try it.
I can't do it, but I'm not good swimming, mate. I can do one breath and then I have to kid on. I'm taking a rest.
Cramp.
I'm terrible. I can't breathe right under the water.
So that coffee you're
drinking. Nobody can breathe under the water.
No, but know how you come up and you...
Yeah, it's difficult.
I can't do that. I just hold my breath the whole time.
More of a breaststroke, man.